Hello, my YouTubian buddy old pals. How are ya? Hope you're doing well. In this video, we're gonna have a look at giving your reverb a little love by the use of a delay 4, which you should recognize since we literally just went through a video about that. If it's your first time to my channel, I hope you like it. If it's not, then you're right on board. You know what's going on. You know how we do things here. Okay, let's not waste any time. Let's start the show. Behold, I give you just a snare sample. That's it. Nothing that exciting. Thank you, Joe Mox, for that. A snare sample. There you have it. And I thought, well, we could do the old thing, you know, you add an effects track and you give it a little bit of reverb love. You go down, do reverb, and you know, send it over. Well, actually, let's do that. And you can listen to it. And you can do the things that you like to do to it. I don't know what you guys do. I'm gonna do something like that. And actually, if you're looking to wash out sound with just reverb, the standard reverb is pretty flexible. I've seen a lot of complaints on the internet about this reverb, but I don't have those complaints. Actually, it's an incredibly flexible reverb. You kind of have to know what's going on inside there, and I have a video that explains a reverb to you. Aside from that, it's just a lot of tinkering around and trying to figure stuff out, and it's somewhat complex, but it's definitely worth getting to know. And I'm growing to love this reverb, although I'll be honest, I still reach for my Lexicon or my Akon Digital or, you know, whatever, that kind of stuff. But this thing is still, it's pretty awesome. But I didn't want to go that route. I wasn't just going to show you a reverb on a snare sample. That would be dumb. So instead, I thought I would do something a little bit outside the box, and that is I loaded up... Whoa, dude. I loaded up a delay... here, and you've probably seen it recently in my channel because we talked about it recently in my channel, and we talked about how the feedback effects are different than the regular effects because the sound that comes out of this is fed right back into it, right? So if this frequency shifter is in my feedback effects, whatever comes out of the feedback or out of the frequency shifter is fed right back in. And so if it's, you know, pitching a sound up an octave, it goes up an octave and then up another octave and so on and so forth until the end of time or until this runs out. And so I thought I would build on that principle. So what I did was I threw on a delay 4 here and I changed the time, changed it from being beat synced over to just time based. And I put it at 10 milliseconds and 16.7 milliseconds. I just wanted a low value. I didn't really know, like I just dragged them down until it sounded neat. And on here is where I put some reverbs. So there you go, two reverbs. And I set them up basically the same way you saw me just do it with it on a track just there. You know, pretty long reverb tail, 8 seconds of reverb. Very few places in the world you're gonna get 8 seconds of reverb naturally. But that's besides the point. So, and then in the feedback effects, I have my frequency shifter shifted up, and I just kind of played around with those, and I did the same thing here. So what I've basically done, I've also turned up 1 and turned up 2, and I fed them back into themselves. So what I've basically done is just give myself options as far as creating more than just an effect out of a reverb. You can really use the reverb, and it almost becomes, I wouldn't say a synth, but it becomes like a tool. Like in this capacity, I wouldn't even call it a reverb. I don't know. It's a modulation of some sort, I guess. But you'll see what I mean. This is definitely not creating an open space like a reverb should. This is getting into some weird stuff. And I'll say this, the Valhalla Shimmer is a reverb placed before a frequency or a pitch shifter, which in the pitch shifter goes up an octave. So your sound goes through the reverb and then into the pitch shifter, and then back into the pitch shifter, and so on and so forth, over and over and over. And that's what a Valhalla Shimmer is. If you know what that is, you know what I'm talking about. If you don't know what a Valhalla Shimmer is, you should check it out online. It's pretty cheap, and it's a widely used kind of washout reverb nowadays, especially amongst the Ableton folks, because they can't create things like this. And so that's why I'm showing you how you can get creative with reverb. Okay, I'll stop yapping. Let's just listen to what I've done here. Okay, so it's really shrill, and it doesn't sound like a reverb anymore at all. Well, I mean, it still has properties of a reverb, but you can see that it's a very sharp and kind of abrasive sound. But as I play with some of this stuff, and I'm not even going to play with the other three effects I put on here, or the other two delays that I'm not even using. I'm just playing with this one single frequency shifter that I've put on this number one, okay? And you'll see what kind of a ridiculous effect it has on the sound. All right, if you're wearing headphones, I'm gonna blow your mind for a sec right now. Isn't that weird? Like, how is that happening? Did you hear that with me, or am I the only one? Am I going crazy? Because it's weird. As I go right, there's like, it's just weird. I hope you heard that. But it's besides the point. All you need to know is that you can play with it. And it's pretty insane. And you can do the same thing on the second instance of the frequency shifter. So yeah, I mean, as far as sound creation, you know, it's pretty awesome. And it's simple. Like, it's a delay four with two reverbs and two frequency shifters. And I'm not even going to take this as far as putting on a whole bunch of LFOs and mods and stuff like that, and audio sidechains, and then an effect inside this cavity here, and then play with, you know, the panning and stuff like that. I won't even do that right now, because I know I can feel you smart folks just thinking right now about all the stuff that you're going to do if you ever decide to open this up and you get bored and you play with it. And so for me, can you say a writer's block tool right here, right? If I have writer's block, I'm gonna mess around with this guy a bunch and just see what comes out. And especially once you assign a rhythm to it, like an LFO and things like that, then it really starts to pull a little creativity out of your brain. Okay, all right, I hope that did something for you. It definitely did something for me. I thought I would just share that quick with you, and I hope you like it. Go ahead and subscribe if you like the video. If not, then I'm sorry. not much more I can say about that. If you have suggestions for future videos, I would definitely like to hear those, because I don't know without you telling me what you want to see. So leave those in the comments below, or if you just have comments or whatever, questions, if you just want to chat, you can do that. Just leave it down below. Or you can follow the Facebook page for this channel, which you can find on the channel home screen, or you can click about and email me. Okay, the typical stuff. You know how it goes. You've watched YouTube before. And yeah. Okay. All right, guys. Take care.